Hey everyone, welcome to this walkthrough on how data is prepared before feeding it to a machine learning or deep learning model. I'm Tansi Saji from Learned Education and let's begin. So first of all, what is data processing? It's simply the techniques that you have to apply on a data so that it is useful for the machine learning model. In most machine learning problems that you will solve, the data you collect or download from sites like Kaggle or Google Dataset Search is not always in its best version for a model. Let's look at this particular dataset that I collected from various sensors. Here you can see that we have different attributes like pH, COD, BOD, ammonia, etc. And you can also see that some of these values are not floating point or numbers. And there is also these infinity values like this one that does not correlate with the rest of the dataset. So a basic agenda of data preprocessing is to remove these non-numerical values, find outliers and infinity values like these, and also remove any inconsistencies or outliers in a given dataset. So let's look at how we can do this. Let's open our code editor and create a file like preprocess.py. Now, at this point, I want to introduce you to a dataset manipulation library called Pandas, which will be super useful for data preprocessing and other things that are associated with data preprocessing. So let's import Pandas, P-A-N-D-A-S, as PD. And we also need another library called NumPy, which is number manipulation for Python. Now the first step will be to import the dataset, which is this one, dataset.xl. So the first step will be to import our dataset, which is dataset.xl. We can do that by creating a variable called df, which means data frame in terms of pandas. So df equals pd.read, since we are reading an Excel, read Excel, and the parameters are dataset, which is the name of the file, dataset.xl, xlsx, xlsx. It's too confusing for me. And as you can see here, we are working with the second sheet, not the first one, second one. So the second parameter of this method is which sheet are you working with. In my case, it's one. Let's take a break and discuss about what we are going to do in this video. So I'm going to talk about data preprocessing, of course. And also, I'm going to talk about data augmentation. Which is creating duplicate data, which is mathematically similar to the original data. We need to do this because of the size of this existing data set we have. Let me just print the length of df. As you can see here, the length, the total number of entries we have is 182. And also if we print the summary of this dataset, we can see that this contains a lot of non-numerical values, like this BDL. I don't know what BDL means, but I don't want this in my model. Also, you can see that we don't want this also because the existence of this attribute in this dataset will negatively affect the entire accuracy of the machine learning model we will create in next video, maybe, most probably. So data preprocessing. First step of data preprocessing is obviously data cleaning. In this process, we will clear all the non numerical values by creating like can't speak and write. Okay, data cleaning. The first step in data cleaning will be to remove these non-alphabetical, non-numerical values with what programmers called not a number, N-A-N. We can do this by this command df equal to df dot apply pd, that is pandas to numeric, and errors. Now there are three types of errors. Let me just quickly open the pandas documentation here. So here you can see there are three types of errors: ignore, raise, and coerce. So since we want to convert all the non-numerical numbers to NaN, we will use the errors error coerce. I don't know what coerce means. Yeah, this will convert all non-numerical values to NaN. We can see that by printing the, oh by the way, if you type df, that is the variable you created, dot add, it will print a sort of summary or first few entries of your dataset. Here you can see that earlier you can see that all the non-numerical values are converted to NaN. The next step will be to remove those NaN values, which can be done by using df equal to df dot drop na. That's it. Here you can see that all those non-numerical values are removed. The second step of data cleaning process is data reduction, which is to reduce all those attributes or remove all those attributes that does not contribute in the overall learning process. In our example, we don't need this TC here, so we can just remove TC entirely. We can do that by typing again df equals df dot drop, just drop, not dot, drop na. Drop na is used to drop all the not a number value, not a number rows, and drop is used to drop a particular row by using row equals the row number, which is one these things. In our case, we want to remove columns. So columns equals the name of the column, which is TC here. And next will be data augmentation part. So I like my data, the synthetic data I create should be mathematically similar to the original data. So what I usually do is I take a number. I first calculate the standard deviation of each attribute, like for example pH here. I calculate the standard deviation of pH and iterate through each row like this one and add a random number between 0 and that standard deviation to this pH. This will create a new value which is similar to this value. So since I want to keep this video short, and let me just write the code and then we will see what each line means. So first step what I did is I separated each attribute which can be accessed by df, which is a associative array, and I accessed each attribute by its name header, which is these values. These must be exactly identical to these, otherwise it will give an error. So I just separated each attributes and calculated standard deviation. Standard deviation is calculated by a numpy's method called std and passing the entire list inside it. This will return an integer, which is the standard deviation of all these numbers. Similarly, I calculated for all parameters I have. Then I created an empty dataset array. So what I did here in this loop, I iterated through each row from the original dataset which can be done by iterRows method of df object, and created a new dictionary called temporary temp, and take the old value and added a random number between 0 and the standard deviation we calculated, and this gave a new number, and just appended this thing to our old dataset. Actually, before doing this, it's better to do this dot append df, and then inside this loop we iterated through each row and appended the new value into it, into the dataset array, and we repeated this process about 20 times, and it's about 20 times, and after that I printed the length of the array. Let's run this process, clear the terminal and run. As you can see, I created 3201 entries from less than 181 entries. So this way we can create new dataset which will not severely affect the learning process but can improve a little bit. So after that, finally, one more thing we have to save. For that, we have a method in Pandas, in fact df object, called df dot, actually we have to make a data frame of this list, because since we are using Pandas, we have to convert everything, every list, in a data frame. A data frame is a list in Pandas. So we can create a data frame by writing pd. Pd is our alias that we give to our Pandas library. pd.dataframe class. We are creating an object of data frame, which is df. And inside this, there is an argument which is the list, that is dataset. This will create a new dataset, data frame, and save that object into this data at df variable. After that, we can write df.save. Let's say I want to save in CSV, so save CSV and write the name of the file line. One last time, let's run this code. Okay, sorry, I did a mistake here. This is not save CSV, it's actually to CSV. And let's clear the terminal and run the process.py file. We are creating new data, around 3200 data, and it's done. So you can see that a new dataset is created called newdataset.csv, and here you can see that I think I did a mistake. Okay, what I did is I appended a data frame at first and then I appended dictionary after that. That's why what happened is this happened. There's the data frame, 181 data frame, and the other dictionaries, which is bad, really, really bad. So let me just fix this bug. So what we can do is we can copy this for loop and remove all these additional standard deviation random number, and it will be appended to the data set, and after that we iterate and do the usual process. So let's just run so let's just run this new file, I mean edited file. Yeah, great. So it's fuck. Okay, nothing happened. Everything is all right. The thing is, these are old files and these are new files. So what is Python float values by default has so many decimal points. So that's what's happening here. So everything is fine. So I think that's all for today.